Hello! Today, I thought it would be really helpful for you guys to learn how I make my fine art prints. First of all, welcome to the fine art print family. Watch me turn this rough sketch into a vector illustration and into this gorgeous product. So, I've taken a couple of steps before arriving here. I created this new sketch, which you can also use as an inspiration. And I've set up my canvas in a very common art print format, which is a vertical A3. It's 297 millimeters wide and 420 millimeters high. This format is ideal because it makes my life easier, it makes the printer's life easier, and it lowers costs. I always recommend you to check with your printer beforehand what their standard formats are. Okay, let's look under the hood. We have one background layer, basically a simple rectangle in light pink, that color that I usually go for. And on a separate layer, I placed my rough sketch. My inspiration was actually an artwork that I saw in a mountain cabin, and I just loosely sketched the pose. And now I'm creating my interpretation of it in vectors. So, let's add a new layer just for that. Let's name it, because if you know me, you'll know that I love staying neat and organized. But you can just follow your own flow, of course. If you're used to working Procreate or sketching on paper, then the pencil tool is going to feel just as natural. And I especially prefer high smoothing when drawing broad strokes like today. Let me pick one color from my palette to draw her body. I like to trace it in parts just because it's easier to control any mistakes that might happen. So in this case, I was not entirely happy with my first shape, so I'm going to redraw it. And then I'm continuing with the rest of her body. Now that I have this shape, I lower the opacity so I can see what I'm doing. Then I will just get back with the node tool to refine the lines that I just drew. So by selecting my shape, I can see all these connecting points here and move them around. I adjust them a little bit. It usually does not need that much work when the smoothing level is high. And that's why I love working with a pencil tool. Notice that once tapped, the notes also have these blue handles that I can adjust to finesse my curves. Here it got a bit wobbly, but all I do is delete any unnecessary anchor points in order to create a path with minimum amount of nodes. Let's move on to the hair. So let's make a new layer and go through the same steps as before. Let's follow these flowy lines. Nice! All in one. Done! Again, working on the nodes a little bit. As usual. I'm happy with this, so I'm just going to add a few hair strands to make it look less neat. It's not in the sketch, but I'll just freestyle. So what I'm going to do is turn fill off, turn stroke on, still using the pencil tool, and I'm going to draw a couple of lines that give the hair a flowy feel. Whoop, okay. Ooh, let's redo this. Yeah, something like this. For this one, I want the ends to taper a little bit, so I'm going to pick a brush. That one from the presets would work just fine. I'm going to make it a tiny bit thicker and adjust until I'm happy. And I want to add a couple more strands that go behind her neck. It's the same procedure, basically. It's funny how much effort goes into simple lines. I sometimes feel like I can tweak lines forever, but at some points I have to remove myself from my artwork and just say, okay, I need to let go of it. I'm going to give more dimension to her body, so I'm tracing this line down her back, and I also want to give it a little bit of a flow, so I'm going to turn it into a brush stroke again. The same goes for all the other lines on her body. They're very minimal and stylized, but they help a lot with giving meaning to the body shape. I've quickly created a bathing suit just because there's nothing new here. And now we can focus on the rest of the composition. Basically, the elements that give that je ne sais quoi factor to the design. First, I created the circle, which I won't leave black, of course. But let's place it in the right order first and make the body layer opaque. Starting off with my trademark rosé, I'm just moving this bubble here to create another pinky peachy color to match. Now, I'm creating a botanical element here with the pencil tool. I actually want these shapes to be wiggly, so it looks good to me. I've colored some leaves in, but I like the contrast with some that are left empty. And once I'm happy with how it looks, I usually group all these elements together so they're easy to handle. Because now I want to duplicate it on the other side. Hold one finger down so you can drag it alongside the same horizontal line. I'm trying to make sure that the woman is framed in the middle, but I do this without any guides. I'm just trying to find the optical center based on the distribution of white and negative space. I know, it sounds more complicated than it is, really. Now, I'm going to add a few more decorative elements, but they are very, very simple, so we're going to fly through the process. But before we see the printed product, let me first explain the difference between a normal print and a fine art print. It's all about the paper involved. Fine art prints are made with high quality archival inks on acid-free papers using a high resolution printer. These exquisite papers have a lifespan of over 100 years and usually don't fade, crack, or turn yellow. I will add all the specifics of my printed file in the description below so you can follow the same steps as me if you'd like. Alright, this is my final design. I added all these extra elements and, of course, don't forget to add your signature. Branding is very important. And let's see the print. Here it is. Look how beautiful and bright the colors turned out. I'm super happy with the outcome, but I'm not done. I added more personality by applying a dry seal at the bottom. I think it just screams femininity, minimalism, and basically Sandra Staub. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for joining me. Follow me at Sandra Staub on Instagram and subscribe to the Vectornator channel for more tutorials. I think you're really gonna love the next one. Bye!